Hello and welcome to my review of the new Weezer album. Everything will be alright in the end. I just heard this album today, took it out for a run, and I gotta say, the first track, it really got to me. I think it was a very good one, Ain't Got Nobody. And also Back to the Shack, really, was a really funny lyric and a really funny song to me. The fun thing is, the Weezer guys have kind of acknowledged in this song that the fans are unhappy with some of the new records, and he's like singing about the aspect of that, and that he, like, he acknowledges that, which is kind of fun. I don't know if he really can say that he has written better songs because of that. I don't think so, but it's kind of a funny lyric subject to have for a song. Then it's a filler song, Eulogy, for a rock band that I really dislike and I really want to talk about that one too much. Lonely Girl is also pretty much filler for me. So the next song I'm going to talk about is The British Are Coming, which I think is a really fun chorus and a really good track. One of the best on the album. After that there's the track Da Vinci, where I think he thinks about doing some relative research on his parents and like finding nothing on Google. He thinks about that, and that's my interpretation of it, but I'm not really 100% sure about that. So I really think the chorus on that one is probably the strongest on the album. It's probably one of the best songs on the album. I think along with The British Are Coming and Ain't Got Nobody, it's one of the strongest songs. Then there's Go Away, which I thought was okay. I don't know about the female vocals, but I think the theme of the song kind of fits the record. It's kind of the same theme as Ain't Got Nobody. So I guess it fits the record pretty well, even though it's kind of a filler, half filler track maybe. Cleopatra, I didn't like that much, but he really took back the swing again on the track Foolish Father. I don't know, I interpreted it like him singing about like his girlfriend's father or something, or a friend's father, but. I watched Anthony Fantano's review, and he thinks it's him singing to his daughter, since he is a father, which I didn't know before I saw that review. So maybe that's the case. It's still a song about forgiveness, kind of an interesting theme. Just like Da Vinci, one of the best lyrics, along with that one on the record. I mean, the other tracks, I mean, the lyrics aren't like really up to speed with what he used to do. I mean, his old lyrics are of course better than the ones of this album. That has been a problem for quite a few albums since Melodraw, so I mean, that's not going to be that big news. But then it gets a little bit more interesting, because they do like this kind of prog thing and makes like this ending where there's three tracks that are like, they are titled The Wasteland, Anonymous, and Return to Ithaka, and they are numbered like 1, 2, 3, like on a prog album, like a Pink Floyd album or something. And this is pretty unusual for a band like Weezer to do something like this, and it's pretty gutsy. So I guess you're taking some chances on this one, which I like. I think it might be a theme for the year. I mean, it's the same with The Voids and Julian Casablancas. They're really taking a lot of chances on that album as well. So, but it's just fun to see what the internet does, that if you have your own niche on the internet, you can do like more out there stuff on your records, and they will still be interesting to a group of people. And I mean, you don't have to have one record of just massive like wannabe hits, and then one of them is a hit. You can do different stuff on the album and still have a song like Ain't Got Nobody, or I think Back to the Shack is a single for this one. I haven't seen the video yet. My brother was talking about the video that we're playing on the moon, so I still gotta check that out. But I gotta say, I mean, this record, it reminds me kind of when Neil Young released Silver and Gold, and everybody was like still comparing it to Harvest and saying it's not like Harvest, and I mean, that's not really taking the album for what it is. I mean, if it's not a good album, that's one thing, but if it's just not as good as an old album that you love, that is not like, I don't think that's the right approach to approach an album at all. Because this one is really one of their stronger efforts since Maladra, but of course it's not as good as Pinkerton. I mean, Pinkerton is my favorite Weezer album. But I mean, when Pinkerton came out, it was really criticized, and I didn't really get it at first either. And I liked the first album so much, and it was different from that one. And I mean, I think this one doesn't really draw from Pinkerton that much. Maybe on the themes of love and loss and stuff like that, but still in the sound, I mean, I think it draws more than from the first album. I mean, Anthony thought they were drawing like more from 2001 Weezer, and that would be Maladra, but I don't know, it's like, I don't really think it sounds like that either, or like new Weezer. It's hard, I mean, it's hard to describe. They have their sound from the beginning, and I don't think it's that far from the sound on the first album in some songs. I mean, you get the like slow-mo effect in the choruses, which is really cool. I just really love their sound. I mean, if they get a few good tracks together, they will always rock. I mean, they are one of the most talented bands from the 90s, and that they're still around to make this kind of album and make it as good as it is. I mean, you can look at other bands from the 90s who are trying to make comebacks now, and everybody's not doing a really good job at making good albums to release with that. I mean, it's the hardest thing. I mean, if the Sex Pistols would do a new album today, it wouldn't be like Nevermind the Bollocks. So I mean, you gotta take it for what it is, but still have some demands for it to be a good album, and I think this lives up to that. So I'm gonna give this 3 out of 5, and I like the album. I don't think all the songs are great. There's some fillers that are pretty annoying, but I think it's as good as Weezer can be in the form that they are today. So 3 out of 5 from me, Andreas.